Step one is always to put a throat pack in and protect the airway. Make sure nothing falls back into the lungs or stomach. And just kind of snake it back and forth into the oropharynx so that it's completely full. That way anything falls back there, very easy for us to just pick it up. Always prophy first. That way you are treatment planning off of clean teeth. Makes it much easier to detect decay and not miss anything. Okay. So, we're going to prep a Cheng crown on tooth number H. The first step I do, occlusal reduction. Okay, then I go interproximal. And a good rule of thumb that I do is the cutting edge of the burr, I usually put that at the reduced occlusal height table, and that's how far I know to go subgingival. Basically, you just have to adjust your reduction depending on where the decay is and how extensive that decay is. So there's still a little bit here, but I'll address that in a second. And then what I do is bevel the lingual. But as you notice, the shapes of the crown are similar to a natural tooth and have that lingual bevel. When I go through, make sure there's no sharp angles anywhere. I'll just touch up that one spot that has a little extra decay. Then you do your pulpotomy or your pulpectomy access. Just come straight in. Open that up. Size 80 file. This just comes right out. Let's go in a couple more times to make sure it's nice and clean. Form a creosote point. Let me let that sit for a little bit. Now I use Vitapex, which is an injectable filling material, which is nice because you can put it to the apex, and as you squeeze, you retract, and you get a nice, perfect fill every time. But because this washes away a little bit easier than regular ZOE, I like to cap it off. Gives it a little more sturdiness. And then I'm also going to prep the tooth next to it, and then we can fit those crowns. So same thing in the front, occlusal reduction. And depending on the decay, it's usually like a millimeter and a half, 2 millimeters. Then you do interproximals. Again, the height of the cutting burr, I put the top of it at the occlusal height of the reduced plane there. And that's usually my guide to know how deep to go. As you can see, as you take away more tooth structure, it becomes more uniform in color. And that kind of just denotes that you're getting to a healthy layer of tooth and no longer have decay, which is what you want. You want solid tooth structure. And then you bevel the lingual again. And then I just make sure there's no sharp angles anywhere. Come in, do your pulpotomy access. Side is nice and clean. While we're waiting, I'll finish prepping the facial tooth E. Apex again, center, inject until you see it come out and retract, and then cap it off. What I like about the Vitapex is it's bactericidal, so it also helps decrease the bacteria count within the internal root structure. Now tooth D. Same thing. Occlusal reduction, interproximal reduction. See, there's an old composite filling on here. Bevel the lingual. Round off any sharp edges. Some crowns. Let's try a right lateral. Let's go 4. Just for funk, I see a 3. I like the way this fits, but I just want to check. Okay, so we're going to go with the threes. Okay. That's nice. Those threes more closely resemble the original shape and size of the teeth. As you notice, they got some pretty decent gapping everywhere. So you want to try to reproduce as closely the original size, which you can do pretty easily. And that fits pretty nicely. So we can cement those. So that's how you do two lateral incisors and one canine. As you can see, turns out pretty good. Extremely stable and durable. In my opinion, one of the nicest restorations you can do. So what we'll do is we'll cement these. Thank you. Go around and remove any excess cement. As you can see, fits perfectly. Gingiva, as long as the patient keeps it clean, will heal extremely nicely within a day or two. And that's it. And that's the exact sound you want to hear. Nice snap into place. Means no adjustment needed. I'll just pop it off. Crown size is set. Take out the formo pellet. You can mix cement. Our crown's fit, cemented, perfect shape and size. Gingival reduction. Okay, interproximal. With any decay or hypocalcifications on the buccal or lingual surface. all right? We don't need that anymore.
I'm going to get it. Don't touch it.
I see a upper right D4. Seated all the way. Check for excess cement. Okay. And that's all she wrote.